हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज श्वेता सोनी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम सेज यूनिवर्सिटी भोपाल. वेलकम्स यू ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ टॉपिक व्हिच इज रिलेटेड टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल लॉ, दैट इज इमरजेंसी प्रोविजंस. एज वी ऑल नो दैट इमरजेंसी प्रोविजंस पोस्टुलेट्स अंडर पार्ट 18 ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फ्रॉम आर्टिकल नंबर 352 टू 360. The Constitution of India, which postulates emergency provision and in which there are three kinds of emergency, have been mentioned in the Indian Constitution. First is national emergency, that is comes under Article number 352, and the state emergency under Article number 356, and financial emergency in Article number 360. So firstly, we will going to discuss about national emergency. According to it, the president may make a proclamation of emergency in respect of whole or any part of India, which means president may make a proclamation in any part of India or whole of India according to the situation. If he is satisfied that a grave emergency exists which threatens the security of India or any part of India by war, external aggression, or armed rebellion. Such proclamation of emergency can be made even before the event mentioned in Article number 352 has actually occurred, provided the president is satisfied that there is a danger of war, external aggression, or rebellion. Student, you have to mark these three points. First is war, second is external aggression or armed rebellion. If there is any kind of thing which shows that there should be a provision which can proclaim the emergency, which in thought of president is reliable, then the national emergency proclaimed through President of India. Emergency cannot be declared merely on the advice of the Prime Minister. The President must communicate it in writing regarding the emergency by the Union Cabinet, including the Prime Minister and the Ministers of Cabinet rank appointed under Article number 75, which means President ko only Prime Minister ko ki hi advice pe emergency proclaim nahi karni hoti hai. प्रेसिडेंट को चाहिए कि वो रिटर्न में कम्युनिकेट करे इस इमरजेंसी के बारे में टू द यूनियन कैबिनेट विच कम्स अंडर आर्टिकल नंबर 75 विच इंक्लूड्स मिनिस्टर्स ऑफ कैबिनेट एंड द प्राइम मिनिस्टर. दीज प्रोविजन यू हैव टू रीड इन आर्टिकल नंबर 352 अलोंग विथ 358 एंड 359 ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. And as you all know that number of national emergency parted in three times in our India. First in 26th of October 1962 to 10th of January 1968 during the India-China war, which was threatened by the external aggression. And in the second instance, it was in 3rd and 17th of December 1971, which was originally proclaimed during the Indo-Pakistan war, and the third proclamation in between of 25th June 1975 to 21st of March 1977 on the basis of internal disturbance. And as you all very well aware of that point, that the proclamation was immediately followed a ruling in the Allahabad High Court, and that voided the Prime Minister election from Rae Bareli in the 1971, which was the Indira Gandhi's premiership, and she was also prohibited from contesting her legitimacy to continue in her post for the very next 6 years, and due to which Indira Gandhi instead recommended to the President Fakhruddin Ali Ahmed to proclaim the state emergency to strengthen her hand. So we can call it the drawback of political leaders. And there are some key points which is related to national emergency, as we already read in the first slide, that only there will be the 3 points, that is war, external aggression, or armed rebellion or insurrection, the president can proclaim national emergency, which was given under Article number 352. And through written recommendation from the cabinet, the president can declare a national emergency. This is also a most important point in it. And within 1 month after its issuance, the proclamation of emergency must be approved by the house, both houses of the parliament. Means, जैसे ही प्रोक्लेमेशन ऑफ इमरजेंसी प्रेसिडेंट के द्वारा अप्रूव की जाती है, उसके विद इन 1 month दोनों हाउसेस ऑफ पार्लियामेंट से ये पास होनी चाहिए. द इमरजेंसी लास्ट फॉर 6 months इफ ग्रांटेड बाय ईच हाउस ऑफ पार्लियामेंट एंड इट कैन बी प्रोलॉन्ग इनडिफाइनाइटली विद द परमिशन ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट एवरी 6 months, विच मीन्स अगर इमरजेंसी प्रोक्लेम कर दी जाती है तो वो 6 months के लिए जो है वो लगी हुई रहती है, एंड वो इनडिफाइनाइट टाइम के लिए, विच मीन्स अनंत काल के लिए लगी रह सकती है अगर पार्लियामेंट उसको एवरी 6 months में क्या कर दे, ग्रांट कर देती है. इफ द लोकसभा वोट्स अ रिजोल्यूशन विथ अ सिंपल मेजोरिटी अपोजिंग द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ अ प्रोक्लेमेशन, द प्रेसिडेंट शुड रिसाइन इट. मतलब अगर लोकसभा एक रेजोल्यूशन पास कर देती है सिंपल मेजोरिटी से जो कि अपोज करता है उस पर्टिकुलर प्रोक्लेमेशन को, तो प्रेसिडेंट को उसे रिसाइन करना चाहिए. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट द स्टेट इमरजेंसी रिलेटेड प्रोविजन व्हिच वाज गिवन अंडर आर्टिकल नंबर 356 ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. एंड इन इट इफ द गवर्नर कन्वेज टू द प्रेसिडेंट by his report that the government of the state cannot be carried on in accordance of the constitution, then the president can proclaim emergency. Which means agar us particular state ke governor ko lagta hai ki state mein emergency lagai jani chahiye, since yahan pe constitutionary machinery fail ho gayi hai. कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मशीनरी मीन्स कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के प्रोविजन के अनुसार शासन नहीं चलाया जा रहा है थ्रू पर्टिकुलर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द स्टेट, दैन ही कैन कन्वे टू द प्रेसिडेंट दैट ही शुड प्रोक्लेम एन स्टेट एमरजेंसी इन दैट पर्टिकुलर स्टेट बाय प्रेसिडेंट विदाउट अप्रूवल ऑफ पार्लियामेंट. द वैलिडिटी ऑफ स्टेट एमरजेंसी इज 2 months. But if the parliament approves a state emergency, then the validity extends to 6 months. मतलब अगर parliament इसे approve कर देती है, तो वो 6 months तक extend हो जाएगी. But अगर before the approval की बात करें, तो within 2 months तक के वो valid रहेगी. And in the very next slide, we will understand about the financial emergency, which empowers the president to proclaim a financial emergency if he is satisfied that a situation has arisen due to which the financial stability or credit of India or any part of its territory is threatened. Which means aisi situation arise ho gayi hai ki hamare yahan financial stability nahi rahi, hum financially utne strong nahi hai, to wahan par president financial emergency proclaim kar sakte hain. Parliamentary approval and duration of that particular emergency is a proclamation declaring financial emergency must be approved by both the houses of parliament within 2 months from the date of its issuance. Means president ne agar issue kar di gayi hai financial emergency, to uske 2 mahine ke baad dono houses of parliament se wo pass hona chahiye, then hi wo continue reh payegi. However, if the proclamation of financial emergency is issued at a time when the Lok Sabha has been dissolved or dissolution of Lok Sabha takes place during period of 2 months without approving the proclamation, then the proclamation survives until 30 days from the first sitting of the Lok Sabha after its reconstitution, provided the Rajya Sabha has in the meantime approved it. Means agar Lok Sabha dissolve ho gayi hai प्रोक्लेमेशन ऑफ फाइनेंशियल एमरजेंसी के समय, या फिर डिसॉल्यूशन के पीरियड में है, तो उसके 2 महीने के बाद जब भी लोकसभा फर्दर फर्स्ट सिटिंग करती है रिकॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के बाद, तो प्रोक्लेमेशन 30 डेज के अंदर अंदर राज्यसभा और लोकसभा से अप्रूव होना चाहिए, देन ही वो सर्वाइव कर पाएगा. Once approved by the both the houses of parliament, the financial emergency continues indefinitely till it is revoked. Which means, अगर एक बार दोनों houses of parliament से ये issue कर दी जाती है तो financial emergency indefinite time के लिए जो है वो लगी रहेगी till it is revoked. These provision related to financial emergency comes under Article number 360 of Indian Constitution. That is for now from the emergency provision. Thank you so much, students. Stay tuned and subscribe to the Sage University Bhopal for more videos. Thank you so much.